The thing that makes me proud when I come into my yard is product. The product means money. If you got no product and you got no piles, then you got no money. Hi, my name's Joe Maggio. I'm the owner of Joe Maggio Construction. I have multiple construction companies, mostly concrete, demolition, garbage, and recycling. I started in construction when I was a little kid with my father doing masonry work. And then when I was around 17, I decided to go out on my own and start my own construction company and started doing concrete work, which expanded into big concrete work, which expanded into machinery, and then brought me into the demolition business. And then recently got into the crushing industry to make and manufacture product for recycling. The reason I got my own crusher is because I relied on other people. And in my industry, relying on other people does not work. You know, it costs you money, downtime. You know, you have no control over your product, your time frames, or your profit margins. So we bring the products in from the job sites, make the product, and then bring the product back into the site to reuse it. Being able to manufacture my own product opened up a whole nother avenue where we weren't limited to times that we could get product. So a lot of the quarries are shut down at certain hours in the morning, they're shut down at night. My guys can preload at night to get on the road earlier hours in the morning. It just expedited the whole process of being productive. Well, I use my crushers when I'm in a yard now, one of my yards, and I use it here because we manufacture RCA, which comes from the concrete companies that I use. So I'm taking their overburden of product and making sellable product for them, limiting the amount of waste that they have on their site. And then when we go do a new superstructure, there's always buildings that come down and we bring the mobile crushers in there to crush the material on site there, and we're able to reuse it back as sub-bases on the sites. So it limits the amount of material going out and the amount of material coming back in. So it made us more efficient for both sides and your profit lines, obviously, too.
Yo, my name is Jim. I work for Joe Maggio. We have two crushers. I run both of them. I basically feed the crusher and move RCA. When I first got it, I thought it was like cool, like just awesome. I mean, it just like eats concrete, and I thought it was a great machine. I was like, holy crap, you can't even believe what it does. The 100 that we have, I mean, the thing is just simple. It's very easy to use. And I knew nothing about this when I started doing this.
Out of all the crushers that we tried, it puts out the best product around. I mean, we have a lot of people up here with recycling facilities that are trying to make product, but if the product's not good enough, it's hard to sell, and then you're overburdened with product. You know, these machines are putting out a product that people were waiting in line to buy.
I ran another crusher, but it was completely different. It was more difficult to use. Really didn't know how to set up the hammers or anything like that. I just didn't think the material was as good as the material I get from the RM machine.
The biggest challenge with this type of equipment is the maintenance end of it. And being able to keep one guy on the equipment that's gonna learn the equipment to be able to expand and teach other people. Because flip-flopping guys on machinery doesn't give them a chance to understand the wares, the maintenances that are involved in the equipment itself. You know, my main guy, Jim, he's the only guy that runs the crushers. So you can't put blame on somebody else. And pretty soon he's at the point where he'll be able to teach another guy and put him on another piece of equipment to teach them the right way. Because if you don't do maintenance, there's no profit.